Now I move to the point by serial correlations. There is a small difference between the point by serial versus the biserial. Biserial, we have two variable, continuous, other one is called artificial dichotomy. But in the point by serial, we need two same kind of two variable, but continuous same as it is of the biserial. But the point by serial, the second variable should be a natural dichotomous. So what's my natural dichotomous? We already discussed. I already mentioned that natural dichotomous means naturally it may divide into two category only. There is no continuum in this. Then it's called as natural dichotomy. Now I'm going to be highlight when we can use these things. Just I'm going to be highlight this one now. For doing a point by serial, we need a two variable. The first variable or variable, first one variable should be continuous. The second variable, natural. So sometimes we may use the term genuine variable or a true variable or in a discrete. So there's a different names are the true, natural, genuine. Everything's the same meaning only. The people are using instead of natural true or instead of natural, they're using genuine also. But dichotomy means you already know that only two classification in natural order, like male, female, then rural, urban, then living, dead, that kind of classification. Now the estimating, the same kind of estimation happen like a biserial, but estimating the relation between the two variable, one variable is in a continuous state, other variable state in a natural genuine dichotomy, we can use the point biserial. Yes, the term dichotomy, we already knows that it may two parts divided into two categories, this we already knows. Yes, so next slide. This slide also the past we are discussing, but now we are focusing only this one only. What is the point biserial? So what is the point biserial? So just I'm skipping this. Yeah, I'm coming back to the, yes, just I'm coming back to once again to my slide. Yes, so see here. So here I'm selecting the pen. The point by serial correlation is used when the dichotomous true or a discrete. True or a discrete. Then we can use the point by serial. Now we are talking about point by serial only. You forget the artificial. When the second variable or the other variable in a dichotomous, but in an actual format, you can go with point by serial. That's all things you have to ensure before doing any correlations. Now see the example. Here I'm focusing. Pass and fail. So see, I'm giving the example. Pass and fail is a natural or artificial. It's a natural or artificial kinetic. Pass and fail. Pass and fail is a natural or artificial. So this is a max test. So yeah, very good. Prasanna. Therefore, this diagram may add for only for where biserial correlation. So it may work for biserial. I'm selecting the other color. So it working for biserial. So this is good for biserial correlation. So this is a biserial correlation example. It's not a point biserial. If you found this kind of data, we can go with the biserial. See here, the matrix is a continuous. Matrix is a continuous. The exam result is a discontinuous. It's nothing but a artificial dichotomous. Therefore, we are using the biserial. Pause and fail. Now I'm moving to this one. Now this is a formula, the same kind of formula. You can look on the formula. What is the difference between the point by serial as well the biserial formula? Only limited. So in the previous formula in down, there is a y. It's nothing but ordinate and the biserial. And the root won't be there. But here, the same looking formula, this first part is same. MP minus MQ divided by sigma is same. MP represent mean of the first group. MQ represent mean of second groups. Sigma is nothing but the standard deviation. P and Q also the same in the biserial will be there. That is called proportion of the first group, proportion of the second group. But here there is no Y. So just I'm going to the previous formula also, then you may easily understand. So this is a biserial formula. The biserial formula, MP minus MQ divided by sigma, the first part is same. Only the second part is different for each equation. The first part, the second part, PQ also same, but there the point biserial root is coming. There is no Y. So only this way it will be differ to each formula. Now see here, I'm coming back to the formula, only the root of PQ. So these things we already know, that's why I'm going to directly to this sum. See the case, the five students have secured the test, follow in a distinguished fast and five. Suppose I am fixing it's a 40 is a pass mark. 40 is a pass mark. What I'm doing, see here, there is a five students only. The students mark 40, 80, 90, 17, 25. So I am giving the the 0-1 score. I'm already I told we can actually divide the group in a Poisson file. Sorry, I'm little confused. Yeah. So in this case, here automatically they fix this law. I already mentioned that Poisson file may comes to the artificial only, but in this case, why I fix like in the sense, for example, in our semester and all, they already given the the mark statement itself, not a mark statement, the examination board is that they divide that the 40 mark internal, 60 mark in the external for passing the minimum 35%. Like there is a thumb rule, is that if there is a thumb rule, we can go with this kind of pass and fail as a natural dichotomous. If don't have that kind of thumb rule, you can go with you can adopt this one. So it's like a semester examination. There is a stipulated divisions order. They told that above 40 is a pass, 40 and above is a pass, 40 and below is to be failed. If they highlighted like this, there is a thumb rule in the sense we can go with these two groups. See here, I'm giving the 40 as a pass mark as a 1, 80 is a pass, 90 is a pass, I'm giving it a 1-1. I hope you understand. It is like a thumb rule when you go for any kind of examination, even for the NET examination, they fix some cutoff. So that cutoff is to be genuine for all the people. It's like a universal cutoff, they fix it. So from this, we can go with this in a sense, it's like, it's good. But here, if you are not having that kind of thumb rule or that kind of cutoff is not there, in the investigative side, they are fixing, then it's called as artificial. So the previously, when I talk about the pass and fail maybe come for the artificial, but in this case, why the pass and fail comes here in the sense, there is a thumb rule for each institute or institution, they fix this a pass mark. Even for the semester, I think the 50% is minimum for clearing the your examination. That's called pass and fail. It's a university norms are there. That kind of university norms, existing norms are there, then you are dividing the groups. Therefore, automatically we meet that this guy is a pass, this guy is a fail. That kind of thumb rule based, if you are dividing the group based on some standard norms, then it's called as a natural. So don't worry about that artificial. If don't have any kind of thumb rule or any kind of standard norms is there, you can go with as an investigative way, you can divide the norms. Already existing norms are there, then you can adopt as an action dichotomous. In this case, above 40, 40 and above is called as a pass marks. Therefore, I'm going with this as an action dichotomous. So here I'm selecting 40 and 1, 80 as a 1, 90 as a 1, 17 as a 0. Why? Because 17 is a fail mark, 20 as a 0 is a fail mark. That is why even the diagram also I fixed like this. See here, this diagram, it may be a artificial, but in the case of the standard norms or the some cutoff made by the some university or the institutions, they already having this kind of norms. Therefore, these norms, we could not be changed as we like. The same norms based, if you are going, we can go with point by seed. Therefore, this diagram, without the intervening of the investigator, based on the standard norms, if you are dividing, then this sum also becomes the point by serial. That's why I'm changing like this. In this case, see here. I hope you understand. Above 40 is called pass mark, 40 and above. The lowest mark is coming the fail. Therefore, the 1 represent pass, then 0 represent fail. So in this case, how many pass are there? So we have the 3 pass students. We have 2 failed students. So this is our data. Now I'm going with the mean of the first group. How we can find out the mean of the first group? Because we wanted the formula. We know the formula. MP and MQ. MP means mean of the first group. I mean pass group. MQ fail group of the mean. For how we can find. So I want to find the mean group first group. So I have to add these 3 scores. What are the 3 scores? Just I'm removing and adding. Yeah, see here, there is a 3 pass scores, 40, 80, and 90. Therefore, I'm giving us a 1-1-1. This additions 40 plus 80 plus 90 divided by 3. It is called 70. It's nothing but MP, mean of the first group, fast group. Parallelly, I want to know the that MQ is nothing but the mean of the fail group. We have only two scores, 17 plus 25 divided by 2 is equal to 21. Therefore, I may found MP as well as the MQ. So if you know the value of MP and MQ, we need P and Q value. The P and Q, we already know this is called as a proportion value. What is proportion? So how many past students are there in our class? 3 out of 5 students. Therefore, the P value is 0.6, 3 by 5. The proportion of failed students, we have only 2 failed students. Number of past students is 5. Therefore, 2 divided by 5 equals 0.6. Similarly, we may know the MT. This is nothing but the mean total. What is the mean total? We can add all the 5 scores divided by 5. For why it's needed, the steps for checking, for finding the standard deviation. So because we need a standard deviation. For doing a standard deviation, for the raw data, we know the formula, summation of x squared divided by n. X in the sense, capital X minus m, m total. Therefore, I need to find the small x here. Small x, I need a x value. X value, we already know that this is our x value, capital X. Empty value, this is our empty value. Therefore, I'm going with, the round off, it comes for 50.5. So it comes to, there's a mistakes happen. Therefore, 40 minus 50.5, it's come 10.4. It's like a 4 only. So there's a typing error. Instead of 5, you can think as a 4. 80 minus 50.4, 29.6. 90 minus 50.4, everything's a 4. So there's a typing error. Yeah. So the typing error. So here, everything's 4. Then only it's come 0.4, then 29.6. This is also 6, 10.6 only. Then 29.6, 36, 9.6. Yeah, 17 minus 51, 33.4. So there is the answers may comes here. Everything 6. Yeah. So after minus, we may get it's the x square value multiplied by x and x square. Then we may get this x square value. Then after getting the x square total, we may easily find out this value, root of summation x square divided by n. Therefore, 4313.5 divided by 5 is equal to 862.7. Is equal to 29.37. There is a error in typing, so you can rectify it. But the answer becomes exactly the same thing only. There is a mistakes happen. Instead of 54.5, in that we are typing wrongly here. You can modify it here. Yes. So now I found this sigma value also. Therefore, according to the formula for the biserial, point biserial, MP, MQ divided by sigma, everything we know, and P and Q also we know. Therefore, I'm going directly to applying MP 70, MQ 21 divided by sigma 29.37 into root of this value. We already know that 0.4 is nothing but P value. Then what is our Q value? 0.6. Then if you go with the solutions, 49 divided by 29.37 divided into root of 0.24, we may get this answer. 1.67 into 0.48, finally we may get 0.18. Therefore, that our point biserial value is 0.8. According to the table of interpretations, it more than 0.5. So it means that the value is a positive. Therefore, it's called high positive correlation. High positive correlation. So I hope you understand how to do a point biserial. So for doing the point by serial, some kind of limitation or when we can use this one, that I'm going to highlight now. The point by serial correlation makes no assumption regarding the form of distribution in a dichotomous variable, where by serial correlations makes too many assumptions, such as continuity, normality, large n, split near to the median. This kind of things is needed for the only for by serial, but go for point by serial, there is no assumptions needed. I am, but normally the point by serial may be used for regression equations. In comparison, the biserial correlation, it may be easily and conveniently to compute compared to the previous one. If you go with the biserial, very big process also, but point by serial for solving is very simple. The point by serial is the product moment R and can be checked against R also. This is usually not possible with R biserial, like a biserial, we cannot do it. And the standard error of biserial correlation, point biserial, can be exactly determined, and its significance can be easily tested against the null hypothesis. So these are some of the positive notes related to the point biserial. I hope you understand the difference between the point by serial as well as the by serial. Just I'm going to summarize these things. Only the two things you have to mind for doing a by serial as well as the point by serial, we need two variables. One variable should be continuous in both the cases. In the both the by serial as well as the point by serial, one should be a continuous nature. Only the second variable, it may be dichotomous. Based on the dichotomous nature, it may be go with the different. If the dichotomous in natural manner, you can go with point by serial. If it is artificial dichotomous, we can go with only by serial only. So based on the second variable or the dichotomous variable nature of the variable only, dichotomy only, we have to adopt it. If it is a natural dichotomy, we can go with point by serial. If it is artificial dichotomy, we can go with the by serial. So I hope you understand. So this is things is describing also. The biserial correlation used to when artificial dichotomy, but the point biserial is used for true or discrete, otherwise it's called natural dichotomy. I hope you understand the difference between the partial, biserial correlation as well as the point biserial correlations. Thank you so much for your passive listening up to now.